looking for a great dinner idea for football season and you love pork sandwiches, just wait until you see official Masterfield Chef Greg Monette's recipe for a crispy pork belly sandwich from Chandler's Restaurant. Greg, it's great to be with you today again.
Thanks, Ashley.
Always nice to be with you. So this recipe is actually on your BBC beer menu, will be, I should say.
Which is coming up in October.
Mm-hmm.
Usually we'll do one every, I think we've done probably seven or eight so far this year. They have other commitments throughout the year as well, as so do I, so do we. But but we're doing one in October and November this year. And this is, I think this is going to be a hit. It's a big, fat pork belly sandwich. And we braise it in a little bit of BBC beer and cider vinegar and kind of keeping with the season. And the toppings are really up to anyone, you know, whatever their preferences are. But what we're going to do today is a little bit of pickled onion, some melted Port Salut cheese, honey Dijon mustard and some greens on some fresh baked ciabatta rolls, and it's gonna be neat.
It is perfect for the season, for sure. And now, this cheese, what kind of cheese is that?
That's Port Salut, which is very similar to like a Fontina.
Mm-hmm.
It's a really mild, soft cheese. It's great for melting. It's perfect on sandwiches.
Oh, well, it looks yummy. It's really tasty.
Yeah, I guess one thing I wanted to talk about was the only real preparation here that may take some time is just braising the pork belly itself. You don't have to. I mean, you could basically just take it, sear it in the pan, finish it in the oven, you know, after a little while, and then you have more of like a pork sandwich. But if you do it this way, the meat on this side is very tender. You've rendered out a lot of the fat actually in the searing process,
mm-hmm.
which is right here, in preparation for before you're braising. Sorry.
So now you braise it in, you said vinegar and cider, so it's a real...
Vinegar, cider, there's a little bit of a veal stock in there. We have some beer in there as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you're going to use beer or wine, you know, that's a little, at times it can be a little acidic, so you want to kind of cut back on some of the other ingredients, like your water, mainly more flavor in it.
Mm-hmm.
So you can cut back on a little bit of water, a little bit of vinegar, because you want those flavors to come out too in it. But this is really just celery, onion, carrot, again, garlic, bay leaves, peppercorns, and then we use the BBC, I think it was the steel rail for this batch,
mm-hmm.
Which we'll probably be serving that night, and they may even just pair it with this.
That sounds like a yummy meal.
Oh, yeah. But really, the process for this is you want to sear this a little bit, render some of the fat, then... tossing your vegetables. It's a mirepoix, so celery, carrot, and onion. A little bit of your garlic and peppercorns and bay leaf, and start adding your liquids. And really just kind of let it simmer for, I would say maybe, I don't know, hour and a half to 2 hours at the most, depending upon how thick this is. And you want it to be nice and tender. And you can see it, actually.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
just, you know, this is really, this is the cut of meat that people, you know, we use for bacon. But this is just another method of preparation.
It smells so good. So once you've done that, then you would...
And we can cut it up.
Cut it up and
throw it back in the pan.
There, yep. Okay.
And we just want to crisp this up a little bit. So it's, you know, you still have the fat there, but a lot of it is rendered out. So it's not as thick of a layer as it would have been normally.
Right. Okay, so then we're going to let that, we'll just finish it up in the pan.
Yep.
Right, we'll let that cook. And, oh gosh, I can't wait to see the finished product. So we will be back to finish up the recipe in just a bit. Stay tuned. We're back in the kitchen with official Masterfield Chef Greg Monette to finish up his crispy pork belly sandwiches. This smells so good.
Doesn't it?
Yes, it does. So yeah. I can't wait for you to finish this up.
I think it really is like the cider and the vinegar there. It's it really comes through in the pork as well. So it's just, it's nice, crispy. You know, it's almost like just a soft, giant slab of bacon.
And again, if you, who doesn't like that? Come on.
Yeah.
And if you don't want to make it at home, it's on your BBC beer menu
of course.
October. So just head to Chandler's and you can get the sandwich for yourself. Okay, so now these are the ciabatta rolls you were saying?
Yep.
And you put them in the oven?
We just kind of warm these up
warm
in the oven
up.
For a minute.
Okay.
Really, I would use any like bulky roll for this, just because there's going to be a lot of juice and stuff coming out of these.
That's so much meat.
They are. They're enormous. It's almost offensive.
My goodness, you've got to bring your appetite if you're going to have that.
Well, and here we're going to put on the Port Salut cheese, really because we have the apple kind of...
The cider flavor.
Right,
yeah.
Exactly. So that's nice with the cheese. I mean, really, you could use a nice hunk of cheddar there, too.
Mm-hmm.
And but
is this kind of cheese? Can you get this cheese in the grocery store? Would you say?
Oh, no, definitely.
Or is this, oh, you can.
I think you can find Port Salut pretty much anywhere. Mm-hmm. If not, I mean, you could find a brie or just a sharp cheddar. I would prefer a sharp cheddar.
So whatever kind of cheese you like.
I love cheddar.
Yeah, I know. Seriously sharp, really sharp. That's good.
Exactly.
Okay, so you loaded the cheese on.
Yep, and these are just some pickled onions that one of my chefs made the other day. We were doing that on a cold cut sandwich at the restaurant.
It smells so good.
Doesn't it? We've done this before. We've done quick pickles for vegetables on the show in the past.
Yes.
And really, it's something simple and easy, and especially right
so
now.
So much flavor.
You've got all the flavors of the harvest, so you should do it at home. And here's a little honey Dijon. Actually, I like a lot of honey Dijon.
Me too.
You want to throw some lettuce on top of it?
Oh, I would love to. I love to help.
Then we can just top these.
Should I just put it right on here?
Yep.
Okay.
And that one's for this one.
All right. Really lettuce on all of them. This is like, I would have to cut this up into quarters or something. I don't know if I could even eat it. It's so big.
No, they're enormous. You can trim it, you know, so that it's a little bit smaller and stuff. So, but one thing, this is my take on the sandwich. And, you know, I think if I thought about it, I should have brought some fresh apples and used those as well.
Well, I guess you could,
but you're just
change it up, add and subtract whatever you want to the sandwich.
You know, even sauerkraut, you know, a different cheese, Swiss cheese. You can make it almost like a Reuben for Gentiles.
Oh, my goodness, Greg, look at that. Oh, wow. I would feel like I'd have to go into my own private room if I was going to eat that. I wouldn't want to have anyone watch me because it would be so.
Right. But that's really
so messy.
That's it.
Oh,
it's just a big fat sandwich.
That is a big fat sandwich. Okay,
fall.
So I'm just going to keep looking at that as my stomach growls. Let's talk about October events taking place at Chandler's.
Yep.
There's quite a bit happening.
Oh no, definitely. And really, well, to start off the month, we do a breast cancer awareness themed event. It's our wine tasting that we do the beginning of Friday of every month. Mm-hmm. All the wines featured, the vineyards donate substantial portions of their sales every year to breast cancer research. And so we're proud to be a part of that. As well as throughout the year, we participate in the American Heart Association events, Jimmy Fund, March of Dimes. And it's just something we feel responsible or obligated to do, really, because we're part of the community. And I work with people with families, and everyone's been touched by a lot of that, you know, throughout the years and stuff. So it's something important to us, so we make a point of that at Chandler's
to give back to so many different organizations.
No,
that's
definitely
great.
And really it is. You're part of the community, so you know, you gotta do something.
Right. And that's the wine tasting that takes place in October, and the details will be on your website.
Exactly. Followed by our beer dinner, which is I think gonna be pretty popular if people see this. And I know Gary and Chris at Berkshire Brewing Company, they sponsored the tour before the event. At the restaurant, and it's always a good amount of people, and they just have a great time. Those guys, they know their beer, definitely.
Absolutely, that's going to be definitely a fun time. Yep. A great menu, I can imagine.
But that's the adult stuff throughout the month. Later on in the month, we have for the kids specifically, the Witch's Ball. We also have Fancy Nancy. On top of that, there's a special reading from a local author. I think it's Joanne Robb. Who's going to be reading from her book. And so really just look on our website, check out our Facebook page. All that is listed on the Channel 22 website. And so it's pretty straightforward access to find out what's going on for the remainder of the month.
There's a lot going on. It's kind of hard to keep track of it all. They can also, if you have any questions, you can always call the restaurant as well.
Exactly.
And if you have any questions about it. Well, Greg, this looks absolutely delicious.
A fat
pork belly sandwich. That's what I'm talking about. That with a beer just... Perfect. So thank you so much for being here.
Thanks,
it's always nice to have you. I always have so much fun. And if you'd like to get this recipe to make it at home, or you could just go to Chandler's and eat it, you can visit our website, mymassappeal.com, and click on Taste Appeal. Official Mass Appeal chef Greg Monette joins us every other Thursday, so be sure to tune in to see what his next delicious recipe will be. And remember, you can stay up to date with the latest events and specials by finding them on Facebook. Just search for Chandler's Restaurant. They are located at 25 Greenfield Road in South Deerfield. Just take exit 24 off I-91 North. If you'd like more information or would like to make a reservation, call 413-665-1277. Still ahead.